We just arrived.
So Adi, he just took over the steering, and now you see already in the background that you're not going straight.
No, it's moving a lot, Adi. I'm freezing.
I'm Adi, and this is Mira, and we are Let's Meet Abroad. We live in the Netherlands, and we have been exploring a lot of local places around. In this video, we'll take you to Giethoorn, which is considered as one of the most touristic places in the Netherlands.
We just arrived in Giethoorn, and this is a really special place in the Netherlands because it's a really cute little village, and everything is connected with water. So yeah, the best way to get around here is to rent a boat, get into the boat, and you can go through the village. And it's really popular among tourists, especially tourists from Asia, but I will explain you later why that is. So Adi, what is your first impression?
It looks pretty cool, and because we are early in the morning, it's really quiet. Things like this we can only imagine in movies where there's no cars, no nothing. It's like Venice.
Venice, in Italy. They call it actually the Venice of the North. They even promote it, like officially promoting it that way. So yeah, but I've never been to Venice, so I cannot compare it.
But then in the photos, what I saw like a lot of tourists.
Yeah, pre-corona time, I think there were around 1 million of tourists coming each year. They don't know the exact amount.
How crazy is that?
Yeah, it was like packed, but it became really a problem. Like they're just, it's not like an open air museum.
You know?
Like people are living here. This is someone's house.
Yeah.
And just being surrounded by tourists all day.
Yeah. How crazy that, like, all these houses, what you see around this canals, they are all residential houses. So imagine that you wake up and you see like all the canals is full of boats and tourists. So we're looking for places to rent the boats around here. I think it's gonna be a lot of fun, and the best part is it's gonna be mainly just us. We have seen just two or three other boats, so that can be cool. So really excited for that.
I just saw this goat, and this reminded me of something, because my parents told me that a long time ago, like thousand years ago, when they discovered this place and they started to live here, they found lots of goat horns in the water. And they say they were there in the water because there was like a disaster, many goats died, and yeah, that's. And then they decided to call this place Geitenhoorn, and that's like goat horn in English. And like through the years, because of the dialect, this Geitenhoorn became Giethoorn. We found a place where we can rent a boat. So 5 minutes later, we're in the boat. It's really cool. It's you can just do it all by yourself, but I must say it's really easy. I see many ducks. I'm really afraid that I will hit a duck.
So we have this boat for an hour, so we'll just try to make the most out of it. And we've got this little map so we can go in this whole circle, and we'll end up in this big lake.
When I was a child, like when I was really young, we went here almost every summer, and I cannot remember that much, but the only thing I do remember from this place, from Giethoorn, is this museum. It's called the Oude Aarde, the Old Earth, and it's really cool. You can buy a stone there, just like a rock, and you can correct the stone. Like it splits, and if you're really lucky, there's like really beautiful, like almost like diamond, looks like diamond stuff inside. So every year we were cracking the stones, and then most of them, they were just blue and stuff inside, also really cool. But just one time, my brother, he got like such really a super pretty one. They even, the museum asked him like, can we buy this over from you? But my brother, he kept it, and it might be still at my parents' place, but you can check that later.
Yeah.
The guy from who we rent the boat, he said like there's a windmill without a fence, and we found it. Yeah, I don't know what happened to them, but it looks a bit sad.
So
guys, now we are entering the bigger part of the lake. So we have already passed the little town, so now we are entering in this huge lake. And this huge lake was frozen, completely frozen 1 week before. And now it's all nice and sunny. So let's see how we go. And I think we have, I think, 40 minutes more to ride. So. And I don't know how far we are again to the main village. But yeah, it looks pretty. I think it's just us in this water. And there's someone sailing there. How cool is that?
We are at the end of our boat trip and it was so much fun, really. It's, yeah, 1 hour round. I think we took a bit longer, but we were making photos like there, and we were put the boat really slow, and it was like a whole queue behind us because suddenly it became really busy. There are lots of people now, so we're just on time. And now we get something to eat, I think, because I'm hungry.
Yeah.
So I promised you guys that I would explain to you why there are so many Asian tourists here. And that's a funny story. There was like a woman here, one woman. I think her name was Gabriella. And she went to China, to Beijing. And she went to this place where they promote your accommodation, you promote your hotel. And she has an hotel here in this in Githorn. And instead of promoting her hotels, she thought, oh, I can better promote the whole city. So she started to promote Githorn in Beijing. And then, yeah, they discovered this place, and since then it's booming. It's crazy how many tourists are coming.
Guys, another vlog with the hot chocolate. So what did we get, Mira?
We have some hot chocolate and I have a red velvet cake, and oh, this hot chocolate is again really, really good. So we are enjoying our hot chocolate and we're sitting in the sun. And it really feels like our first little holiday in the Netherlands since Adi is here. So we are back home and we thought, let's do a little conclusion about our visit to Githorn. And yeah, we were discussing about it, like, would we recommend other people to also go to Githorn if you just have a few days in the Netherlands? And I think, yeah, if you have the time and it's not peak season, then you should go to Githorn. It's really a place, I haven't seen places like this somewhere else. Yeah, maybe Venice, but I haven't been there. But it's really like one of a kind. And but I must say, I believe in high season, then it must be so crowded. The streets and the canals are really narrow, so it's not really easy to pass people. And I can imagine if it's like packed, then the fun is gone. So yeah, if you're just before high season or after high season, I think it's perfect. With, of course, nice weather.
And guys, same thing with the photos. Like, we were trying to make some photos, and because everything was so jam-packed that we were not able to get some really good photos. I can imagine in peak season how crazy it would be. But anyways, guys, we really hope that you like this video. Give us a like, that just helps us more to get discovered to the people who are yet to discover our channel. And yeah, thank you so much again for watching. And spring is coming, as you can see, so we would be exploring a lot more places in the Netherlands and probably abroad. I don't know.
Nah.
I have no idea. We'll see.
The Netherlands is good enough.
Yeah, and yeah, thank you so much for watching, guys, and see you guys in the next video.
Bye.